So even though the modern ideal of beauty is becoming more globalized, one size definitely does not fit all. My guests have some thoughts on that. Dr. Ivor Lim is a cosmetic surgeon who's worked in the UK and Singapore. Over the past 10 years, he's seen lots of changes in his field. And Elisabetta Franzoso is a corporate trainer, personal coach, and motivational speaker who has had her own battles with body image. She writes about it in her upcoming book, How Stella's Mum Got Her Groove Back. Welcome to you both.
Thank you very much, Mae.
Thank you very much, honey.
Elisabetta, let me begin with you. You've been counseling people over the years, a lot of women, a lot of them with body image issues. What have you seen that's changed over the years where people have become so much more concerned about this?
First of all, I think there is more awareness about first impression, something that maybe before when women were working more in-house than outside at work, that was not something that was so much present. So, of course, now there is more attention on the way that you dress for first impression, the way that you look. Your body image really gets, a priority.
Right, and also that exhibit was talking about the media, magazines, things like
Absolutely.
That have such
the message,
great influence,
great
right?
Great influence on young and no young people as well.
Yeah, all across the board,
all,
right?
Yeah.
Well, I whenever I think about these issues, and especially with young girls, it also has to come from the adults. I mean, with mothers and older sisters and women who they hear them saying, oh, I'm fat, oh, I got to go on a diet, I got to do this, and they're going to absorb all of that.
Of course, yes. Because parents are role models. So you have to be the one, as a mother myself, I know, to set up the role for your daughter. So, for example, I have clients that came in session, and there is a, literature that you can read around that, where the eating disorder came from mothers and even from grandmothers. And it was perpetuated because there was no education. And so how can you break the chain if you don't know? So for me, it's about creating awareness.
Yes.
And this is the fantastic way. So I didn't know that. So fantastic. Yeah. Welcome. Welcome that in Singapore.
And that's I think, is in line with the research that we have done. In fact, the top key influences on the perception of beauty is actually mothers, their peers, and the media do play a large extent to their perception on beauty.
Of course.
I have to agree that it all starts very, very young, because I see my three-year-old girl, Pippa, who is following her older sisters, Alex and Georgia. And she's growing up so quickly because they truly influence her. And she's already putting on the bit of makeup and the lipstick and raids my wife's makeup box and that sort of thing.
Right.
I just quietly stand by the side and read newspapers and try not to be involved too much. Yeah.
But there's got to be a balance, right?
Absolutely.
I mean, look, we're certainly not condemning anything right now on this show, but we are talking about the balance of things.
And sorry if I interrupt you. I think that with my daughter, and she's here, so maybe you can also ask her. For me, is always the reminder when she asks for approval, because children come to you to ask for approval.
Yeah.
Do you like me, mommy? Or is it okay the way that I dress? I say what I think I need to say, but I always remind her, your beauty comes from the inside.
And that's the lesson that needs to be taught through and through. Ivor, I wonder, when you do receive patients, do you, from an older woman's point of view, with a daughter, I mean, do you see where a mother could possibly try and be a better role model in terms of projecting those positive messages, and yet she's coming to you to try and change herself.
Yes.
Is that something that you kind of see and struggle with?
A little bit, because we do get the younger ladies coming in with parents and who are quite determined that their daughters have a certain thing or other done. There is definitely a very, very strong influence, paternal influence on children's behavior. But usually I always tell my patients, if your parents may suggest this, but you have to do it yourself. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, there'll be no satisfaction with the result, and I could just as well just be doing it for nothing.
Yeah.
And I would rather the patient want it herself. And normally they'll say, yeah, you know what, when you do that, and I can see I look a bit more like this, it looks quite good, and we'll just go ahead with that. But I think in that situation, it really is, it might be the child wanting a procedure done and wants parental approval, or the converse of the parents wanting something done for the child and wanting the child to accept the procedure. Yeah. So I try and strike a balance in either situation.
Yeah, probably not easy at times, though.
It's not that easy.
Yeah,
it's more
yeah.
difficult when you get the ladies who come in when the boyfriends want them to have a boob job. Now, that's
right. Well, that's just not a good answer at all. So,
right.
But overall, it really does come down to education, doesn't
yes.
it?
Absolutely.
And
yeah,
I mean, do you think there's enough of that, though, in Asia? No, right?
But not only in Asia. I would say everywhere.
Anywhere.
Everywhere. But, you know, if we talk about Asia, because recently the change in women has been so fast, you know, in the past 20 years, women changed so much in Asia. Something that, for example, in Europe started already in the early 50s, 60s. So the timing was really very short. So it was also very short time to create education. So we're still in time. Mm. So we are here to send out the message that more education is needed.
I think we believe in preventing a problem because in our research, we know that women's attitudes towards beauty is formed at a very young age.
Yep.
So you have to start educating from them since young.
Yeah.
You have to let them know that there's actually a broader definition of beauty out there
exactly.
than to wait until a problem surfaced much later on.
That's why the campaign's so good.
Yes.
Thank you so much, all of you, for being on the show. Definitely appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Well, stay with us because we have some super information for you on simple foods that pack a punch. Back in a moment.